Are you tired of using a clunky and outdated text editor for your development needs? Look no further than Neovim with Astro. Neovim is a modern, highly customizable text editor that can greatly improve your coding efficiency and productivity. With the AstroNvim configuration, you can take your coding game to the next level in no time. In this video, I will guide you through the process of setting up your editor with Astro and will explore some of its most useful features. By default, Neovim has a bare-bones interface that lacks essential features like code highlighting, language diagnostics, formatting, linting, Git integration, and a file explorer. Astro, on the other hand, provides all of these and much more, making it an indispensable tool for any developer. Even if you are new to Neovim and Lua, don't worry, I've included some links in the description to help you get started. Now let's dive in and set up Neovim with Astro together. In the first part of this video, I will walk through the installation process and help you configure your editor to support your preferred languages and plugins. Then, we'll take a closer look at how to use Astro to streamline your development workflow and maximize your productivity. Before we begin, it's important to back up your current Neovim configuration. The first step is to install Astro by using this git clone command. This will clone Astro into your Neovim configuration directory. Once installed, you can launch Neovim with the nvim command, and you will immediately see Lazy, the plugin manager, download all of Astro's dependencies. For now, close Neovim with Ctrl Q. To set up your user configuration in Astro, use their GitHub template to create a new repository. Once you have created the repository, clone it using either SSH or HTTPS under the user directory of your Neovim configuration. After cloning, navigate to the directory and relaunch Neovim. Lazy will be displayed again, and this time, you can close it with the Q key. Astro follows a leader key convention, where most actions are triggered by pressing the space key, followed by another key. For example, you can press space followed by E to open the file explorer. Within NeoTree, you can navigate using the H, J, K, L keys. To open directories, use the L key and use H to close them. Let's navigate to the init.lua file and open it with the L key. Astro uses Lua, a simple scripting language, for configuration. Init.lua contains important settings for Astro, such as for the updater, the color scheme, the formatter, and a polish function that can run any code at the end of initialization. To return focus to NeoTree, press space, then O. Now, let's take a look at adding a key mapping in Astro. Mappings are defined in the mappings.lua file, and are separated by mode. For example, N is for normal mode, T is for terminal, I is for insert, V is for visual, and so on. You can also set mappings for plugins, which we'll cover shortly. For now, let's add a new mapping for the leader key, followed by A, to run an echo command. To execute the command, you must end it with CR. This stands for carriage return, which represents the enter key. This is equivalent to doing colon, echo, hello world, and pressing enter. After saving your changes with Ctrl S and exiting Neovim with Ctrl Q, launch it again, then press the space key followed by A to see the message printed at the bottom. To configure plugins in Astro, you can create files with any name inside the plugins directory. For example, inside the treesitter.lua file, you can see that it returns the configuration for treesitter, which is a code highlighter. The first string in the table identifies the plugin by its name. To use treesitter, you must install language parsers individually. You can either add them inside the ensure installed option, or use the colon ts install command. I prefer to add them to ensure installed, as it will automatically install them on any computer where I use my configuration. After restarting and opening a Lua file, treesitter automatically installs the parser, and full code highlighting is now available in the buffer. Next, we have mason.lua, which contains the configuration for multiple plugins inside the table. The Mason plugin manages external editor tooling, such as language servers, linters, formatters, and debuggers. Let's first look at lspconfig, which configures the language servers. Language servers are programs that provide language-specific features, such as code completion and diagnostics. They use a uniform protocol, allowing editors such as VS Code and Neovim to easily integrate with them. Similar to treesitter, you can use ensure installed to install a language server, or use the colon lspinstall command. Next, we have nullls, which is similar to lspconfig, but designed for tools that don't have a language server, such as some formatters and linters. You can add a source using ensure installed, or use the colon nullls install command. Finally, we have DAP, which stands for Debug Adapter Protocol, and enables language debuggers. Just like before, you can use ensure installed or :dap install to install an adapter. For more help setting up LSPs and DAPs, refer to Astro's documentation or the list of all Mason packages with the links in the description. After saving and restarting, the packages will be installed and loaded. In the bottom right corner of the screen, notice that Style Lua is loaded, however Lua LS has not yet been loaded. This is normal when installing a language server for the first time. To enable it, use the :e command to reload the file. Now you can see that the Lua language server is analyzing the code and providing diagnostics. Let's install our first plugin. We'll use a plugin that highlights to-do comments as an example. Find the plugin name, which is usually the GitHub username and repository. If the plugin has any dependencies, you'll need to add them as well. Sometimes, dependencies can be listed under Packer's requires key. As noted on the plugins page, you'll need to call the plugin setup method to configure it. Add this plugin to user.lua. Note that you can choose your own plugin file names. Start by writing the plugin name, followed by its dependencies, and set the config field, which is called when initializing the plugin. Use it to call the plugin setup method to configure its options. Alternatively, you can define the ops field, which automatically calls the plugin setup method with the arguments passed. This makes these two tables equivalent. By default, the plugin manager will lazy load plugins to improve performance. I'll leave it up to you to figure out why it's called lazy. You can specify events, commands, or mappings that will load the plugin. You can also disable lazy loading altogether for the plugin by setting the lazy key to false. In this case, to have the plugin load when a file is opened, use the user astrofile event. Here are some other common events you can use to load plugins. The very lazy event is useful to load plugins on startup. After restarting, you can see lazy installed the new plugins. Press Q to close it, then reopen the file using NeoTree with leader, then O. You should see that to-dos are now highlighted. These steps can be applied to the thousands of plugins designed to improve your productivity and efficiency. In addition to events, you can also use commands and mappings to trigger the loading of the plugin. For example, the :todoquickfix command brings up a quick fix list of all the to-dos in the project. Close it by pressing Ctrl+Q. However, if you restart Neovim and try to run this command, it will fail because the plugin is only configured to load when opening a file. To fix this, you can use the CMD option to specify which commands should also load the plugin. You can also create mappings using the keys option, which will also load the plugin. For example, let's make leader, then uppercase T, open telescope with the to-dos. Initially, the plugin won't be loaded, but once you use space uppercase T, it will load and run the command. By configuring these additional triggers, you can ensure that the plugin is always available when you need it, regardless of how it is accessed. One of the key features of Astro is its community plugin configurations, available through Astro Community. With just a single line of code, you can install and configure various plugins for project management, utilities, color schemes, and language packs. For instance, by adding an import for the TypeScript pack in the community.lua file and restarting, you can see that additional plugins are installed. If the file type is then set to TypeScript and some code is written, you will see syntax highlighting and that the TypeScript language server, TS server, is working in the right of the status bar. Additionally, you can include a color scheme, such as Tokyo Night. To activate it on load, set it in your init.lua or use the :color scheme command to load it immediately. Let's now take a look at the features of Astro. The first feature we will look at is called Which Key. By pressing the leader key, which is mapped to space by default, you can see a pop-up that displays all the mappings that can follow it. This includes your custom mappings as well. The items listed in blue, such as Find and Git, are submenus. By pressing F, you can see additional mappings for the Find menu. I encourage you to explore all the default key mappings. The first mappings we will look at are Finding Files and the File History. To bring up Telescope, a powerful Fuzzy Finder plugin, press F again. By default, you are in insert mode, indicated by the line cursor. Start typing to filter down the results. To scroll down in the results list, use Ctrl+J. And to scroll back up, use Ctrl+K. On the right-hand side, a preview of the file is shown, which you can scroll in with Ctrl+D and Ctrl+U. You can press Escape to exit insert mode and enter normal mode, where you can use H and L to navigate the input box, and J and K to navigate through the results. use question mark to see a list of all the mappings available inside Telescope. Some useful mappings are Control P and Control N, which let you see what you last searched for. As listed in the menu, you can hit Escape once more to exit Telescope. Let's reopen our file search with Leader, then F again, and filter for a file. You can press Enter to open the file. You can also use Telescope to search for recent files by hitting the Leader key, then F, then O. To quickly close Telescope, press Escape twice. To search for text in all files in the project with Telescope's grep mode, use Leader, then F, then W. Once again, you can filter by typing, use Ctrl J to scroll, and press Enter to jump to it. To search for the word currently under the cursor, use Leader, F, then C. This allows you to quickly find any occurrences of a word in your project. Another useful mapping is Leader, then Slash, which comments out the current line. Pressing these keys again will uncomment the line. By selecting multiple lines and pressing Leader, which key will show you the mappings available in visual mode. You can then use Slash to comment out the entire selection. To create a new empty buffer, press Leader, then N. To close the current buffer, use Leader, then C. To go to the buffer to the right, use the right square bracket, then B. Conversely, use the left square bracket, then B, to go to the left. To view all the NeoTree mappings, use Leader, then E, to open NeoTree, followed by question mark. Some useful mappings for NeoTree are uppercase H to toggle hidden files, A to create a new file or directory, R to rename, and D to delete. To navigate between splits, such as Neovim and the empty buffer here, use Ctrl and HJKL. In this case, Ctrl L will focus the buffer. You can create a horizontal split with Leader, then backslash, and then again use Ctrl K or Ctrl J to navigate between them. You can also create a vertical split with Leader, then pipe. Splits can be resized by using Ctrl and the arrow keys, and close with Ctrl Q. You can move the current buffer tab to the right with the right angle bracket, then B, and to the left with the left angle bracket, then B. Astro has many Git integrations, such as the colored indicators to the left of the line numbers. Green indicates additions, red indicates deletions, and orange indicates changes. You can view the current branch and changes on the left of the status bar. To see all of the Git mappings, use Leader, then G. Using Leader, G, G will launch LazyGit if it is installed on your system. Use Q to close it. To see the Git status of all changed files within Telescope, use Leader, G, T. Additionally, in NeoTree, you can use the left and right angle brackets to navigate to the Git tab, which also shows the Git status. Astro also has excellent language integration. Let's take a look. As soon as you start typing, you can see code completion and highlighting. In insert mode, you can also manually bring up completions with Control Space and close them with Control E. You can also see the language server report diagnostics and show types as you code. To preview the type of the symbol under the cursor, use uppercase K. For symbols, use G, then uppercase T to go to its type definition, and Control O to go back. Using G, uppercase I will bring you to its implementation instead. You can also use G, D to jump to a symbol's definition, or use G, R to see its references across the project. When errors are present, use G, L to see the full message, and use G, L again to jump inside the message pop-up. This also applies when using uppercase K twice. Use Q to close the pop-up. You can use the left and right square brackets, then D, to navigate between the errors in the buffer, or use Leader, L, then uppercase D to see all diagnostics. You can use Leader, L, R to rename symbols, or use Leader, L, F to format the buffer. To bring up code actions, use Leader, L, A, and press Enter to apply one. To toggle the floating terminal, use F7. Another useful tip is that when in insert mode, you can type JJ or JK as a replacement to pressing Escape. I would, however, recommend mapping the caps lock key to Escape at the operating system level, as it's a much more ergonomic movement. You can save a session with Leader, uppercase S, then S, and load the session back up with Leader, uppercase S, then period. Although you can do everything with your keyboard, you can also use your mouse for most actions, such as focusing, changing and closing buffers, opening files, selecting tabs, changing Git branches, and seeing detailed LSP information. You can also make selections or hold Alt to create block selections. Use Control click on a symbol to jump to its definition and click inside breadcrumbs. The last feature we'll be looking at is folding. This may be slightly different in Neovim 0.9 or newer. First, set the number of folds to show next to the line numbers with colon set full columns equals 2. This will also show nested folds. Toggle the current fold with ZA. Use ZM for more folding for the entire buffer or ZR to reduce all folds. Folds are also clickable. In conclusion, AstroNvim supercharges your Neovim. It allows you to get started and feel productive in just a few minutes. Now it's up to you to take this knowledge and incorporate it into your development workflow. Explore Neovim's vast library of plugins, and you'll be well on your way to become a more efficient and productive developer. Thanks for watching.